Today I'm at the off-road park called Make It or Break It. I have brought the vintage off-road wrecker out here. This truck has open differentials, so I expect I may not be able to keep up with these guys. The Explorer with the tractor tires has a mini spool in the back, so at least he has a locked rear end. I'll try to keep up as much as I can, but if I can't keep up with these guys, I'll at least find the shortcomings of the truck and figure out what I need to do next. I have upgraded it a little bit since I took it off-roading the first time. The first time I found that my biggest handicap was having manual steering, so I do have power steering now. We'll see if that makes all the difference. And today should show what I need to upgrade most on the truck to make it even better. They're putting the Explorers and me in the middle, because we're the most likely to get stuck. I have the truck in four-wheel drive and low range, so I'm just crawling along in second gear right now. Looks like Ron got a little overzealous and got stuck already. Big mud hole here. The white Explorer wants to try the hole that the truggy got stuck in. But he's gonna go through the other direction so he doesn't have to climb this big hill here. Neither of the wheels on this side are spinning. Might need a winch for this one.
Did it shut off? It shut off. Okay. So, might be unhappy. And the battery light came on, so it's probably connections.
Space for
starter's out of the Explorer. Now he's taking it down to the river so that he can try to wash the mud out of it. We'll see if that makes it work or not. Looks like that worked. The Explorer is running again. We can make our way into the park finally. Explorer got high centered, he's trying to push it over. The Explorers tried to come down the way I came and ended up flipping over.
I'd say it's probably out of there.
most of them were Explorer to come down. So far, I think everyone has been impressed with the wrecker. I haven't had any issues with the power steering. I think when I first came in, I heard it squealing just a slight bit. Maybe it was the alternator charging the battery up, but I haven't heard anything from the power steering belt since. And so far, not having lockers hasn't been a problem either. We'll keep working our way in, and maybe this truck's handicap will show up.
Oh, was he?
Ron's about to see if the Explorer will start. Sounds fine. It's not even smoking. A little bit. Both of his axles.
But if you had the tractor tires on, it wouldn't made it.
I don't know it, buddy.
Well, this is going to be the first recovery for the old tow truck. Just doing it off the pintle hitch. Ron's trying to push the windshield out now so it doesn't hurt anyone. It's better to just take it out of the vehicle.
Start. Love it.
Thank you. having trouble having the power to get up here. Just can't quite make it. This one doesn't have low range. Almost made it. Still moving. Didn't have the power to get up this hill. Pull the first one up and we'll see if I and the tow truck and the other Explorer can get up here. That I'm enjoying is this truck doesn't feel too big for these trails. It actually still feels smaller than my full-size Bronco.
tires got stung by something.
You need a stinger link thing?
I got stung by one here a couple days ago. I got stung right here. Then a whole bunch of them built a nest in my dually. And while I was driving, they started coming out of the door.
The nest is fine. God, yeah, when I got in, it had like...
Ron did put a mini spool in the back of this one. This is a pretty capable Explorer now. Basically at the back side of the park, as far away as you can get right now. It's about almost 4 o'clock, so we have a long ways to go because it's slow going. We've already left one rig. We have a couple rigs that are not doing so well. Just trying to get out of here by dark now. Okay, this is what we have to get through. This is some real sticky mud. I think the engine died and they have trouble starting that. You can't start it with the key. This is some real nasty mud right here. White Explorer died in the water again. Stuck pretty bad this time. I don't know how we're gonna get it out.
I didn't realize there's a path around it.
Yeah, you say that now.
Pushing it through the mud hole. I've tried this before. My FJ40, I had a hard time because it was lifting up the axles. And I don't have lockers on my FJ40. I did eventually make it up here, but it was rough. Yeah, same thing's happening to that Explorer. It's just gonna spin opposite ends. And I might have the same problem with this truck. Let's go give him a little bump. Did it? looks like this one's two-wheel drive now. Broke the front drive shaft.
Blowed up, sir.
Well, the White Explorer has a problem now. In order to start it, you have to get under the hood, but the hood will not open now that the other truck drove on top of it, and it's stuck shut. Stuck in here. We're really stuck in here. I've been pretty impressed today with the vintage off-road wrecker. I didn't get stuck at all. There was only one time where I reversed and it spun opposite wheels, so the open diffs don't seem to be as big of a problem as I thought they would be. I'll have to sit down and think up what the next project for this truck's going to be. So if you want to see more videos on this truck, comment below and click subscribe. Looks like the White Explorer overheated trying to get up that hill. I think it's been determined to pull the White Explorer out up this old creek bed instead of trying to get them up the hill that I just came up. Everyone is on their way out that direction. So I will meet them back at the parking lot.